Good morning. We are going to determine the coefficient of kinetic friction between the book and the incline, given the following information.
Flippin' physics!
Bo, please tell me what we know.
Well, it looks like the angle of the incline theta is 14 degrees. The change in time is 2.05 seconds. And the displacement of the book is 0.78 meters. Oh, and the initial velocity of the book is zero. And the coefficient of kinetic friction between the book and the incline equals question mark.
Good. Because the displacement is neither directly in the x direction nor the y direction, but rather parallel to the incline, I have labeled the displacement delta d parallel for the displacement parallel to the incline. In addition to that, because the book is moving parallel to the incline, I have labeled the initial velocity parallel, which is equal to zero. Bobby, what should we do next?
Draw the free body diagram.
Yes, please, draw the free body diagram.
Okay. The force of gravity is straight down. The force normal is up and perpendicular to the incline. And the force of kinetic friction is parallel to the incline and opposes the sliding of the book, so up the incline.
And we can break the force of gravity into its components and redraw the free body diagram. So now instead of the force of gravity straight down, we have its components. The force of gravity perpendicular, which is perpendicular to the incline and down, and the force of gravity parallel, which is parallel to the incline and down. So we have drawn our free body diagram, we've broken forces into components, and we've redrawn the free body diagram. Billy, what should we do next?
Let's sum the forces. The net force in the perpendicular direction equals force normal minus force of gravity perpendicular, which then equals mass times the acceleration in the perpendicular direction. The book is not moving perpendicular to the incline, so the acceleration in the perpendicular direction is zero. Therefore, the force normal equals the force of gravity perpendicular, and the equation for the force of gravity perpendicular is mass times acceleration due to gravity times the cosine of the incline angle. And we can put that in our equation holster.
Bobby, please keep going.
Now we can sum the forces in the parallel direction. The net force in the parallel direction equals force of kinetic friction minus force of gravity parallel, which equals mass times acceleration in the parallel direction.
We can substitute the coefficient of kinetic friction times force normal for the force of kinetic friction.
And mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta for the force of gravity parallel.
And then from our equation holster, we can substitute mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta for the force normal. We now have the coefficient of kinetic friction times mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta minus mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta equals mass times acceleration parallel.
Everybody brought mass to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
We can add the acceleration due to gravity times the sine of theta to both sides, and then divide both sides by the acceleration due to gravity times the cosine of theta to get the coefficient of kinetic friction equals the acceleration due to gravity times the sine of the incline angle plus the acceleration in the parallel direction, all divided by the acceleration due to gravity times the cosine of the incline angle. And, Bo, what is the one variable we still need in this equation in order to solve for the coefficient of kinetic friction?
The acceleration in the parallel direction.
And how are we going to find the acceleration in the parallel direction?
We can use a uniformly accelerated motion equation.
That is correct. Please do so.
We can use the equation displacement parallel equals velocity initial parallel times change in time plus 1/2 times acceleration parallel times change in time squared. The initial velocity is zero, so that term cancels out. We can multiply by 2 and then divide by change in time squared to get acceleration parallel equals 2 times displacement parallel divided by change in time squared. With numbers, that is 2 times
0.78 divided by 2.05 squared, which is 0.371208 meters per second squared. And we can substitute that number into the equation we have for the coefficient of kinetic friction, which equals 9.81 times sine of 14 plus 0.371208 divided by 9.81 times cosine of 14, which is 0.288326, or 0.29 with two significant digits.
Wait a second. Last time, didn't we get 0.27 for the coefficient of static friction between that book and that incline?
Dang and blast! That doesn't make any sense! The coefficient of kinetic friction is supposed to be less than the coefficient of static friction.
That is correct. There is a mistake in this solution. The acceleration should be negative because the book is speeding up in a negative direction.
Right, but that comes from the fact that the displacement in the parallel direction should be negative 0.78 meters. As you said, the book is moving in a negative direction.
Yes, the displacement is negative. Notice, when we sum the forces in the parallel direction, the force of gravity parallel was negative because we said down and to the left was negative. And that makes the acceleration negative, which makes the coefficient of kinetic friction 0.21, which is, as it should be, less than the coefficient of static friction we got before of 0.27. You have to be very careful to remember which directions are positive and which directions are negative, please. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.